I get a lot of questions from you about vibration, vibration noise, or just the sensation of vibration in your apartment. And many of you have asked, what can you do about it when the vibration is coming from downstairs or from outside an HVAC system? And I know it's a huge problem. And I know some of you live in situations where you're in an apartment building, you have a landlord, you have a neighbor who doesn't believe you. And what I wanted to do was ask an acoustics expert what to do. He's going to join us today and answer that question for you. So let me introduce him to you.
I'm Al Fierstein. I founded Acoustilog 47 years ago. I'm an acoustic consultant in New York. I do work in New York, New Jersey, around, and sometimes other countries, other states. I try to help people solve noise problems. Sometimes it involves measuring the noise and giving recommendations for fixes. Sometimes it involves measuring the noise and testifying in court that some bad actor is refusing to do the right thing with regard to turning the sound down, acting in a different way, or soundproofing. The answer is, generally speaking, the idea for reducing vibration is to disconnect it from whatever it's getting to. And the ideal disconnection is to have it not touching and it be separated by vacuum. But the vacuum is generally not going to occur on the planet, so air is the next best thing. So if you have a fan, for instance, in a restaurant that is hanging from the ceiling, and there's people living in an apartment right upstairs from that ceiling, the floor is going to vibrate because it's connected rigidly to the ceiling in most cases. So what can be done is to do one of two things. You can stop the sound at the source from vibrating the ceiling by having the fan be hung from springs. You can stop the sound from going through the ceiling and floor combination by having a super, super thick floor, like a 12-inch or more concrete slab, which generally is not an option for people who already live in an existing building. And finally, you can go to the floor above and put what you call the anti-vibration pads underneath the bed or underneath the entire floor. That's called stopping the sound or the vibration at the receiver.
That is really interesting that you say that, because several people have asked me that very thing, because I did the videos on these anti-vibration pads that are made of rubber and with cork in the middle, like little sandwiches with tire tread. And I always said it's really probably not going to work. You know, they asked exactly that. Can I put them under my bed or something? And I said, no.
Hold on a second. I'll be right back. These are anti-vibration pads. Okay.
Yep.
This one is 1 inch thick, 2 inches by 2 inches. Okay. It's made of fiberglass. Fiberglass is not green. This is green. It's coated with green rubber. The reason is fiberglass, when it's waterlogged and soaking wet, doesn't work as a vibration isolator, but it does when it's dry. The green keeps water out in case it's on a floor or under a floor and you have a leak. You don't want your pads to be ruined. This is a type of vibration isolator, professional type. It's got a base plate. It's made of metal. It's got a insert for a bolt on the top. It's threaded, made of metal. But the metal base plate is covered with rubber. This black pyramid-shaped object is also made of rubber. The metal nut inside here that accepts the bolt is mounted inside the rubber and is not rigidly connected to the metal base plate. Mm-hmm. Only rubber connects the two. But the rubber is more stiff than air. So you could put this under the feet of a bed because, as I said, the way to stop the vibration from going from one place to another, in the example I gave with the ceiling fan, is to stop it at the source by preventing it from getting into the ceiling, stopping it in the path, which is the ceiling itself, by making it ultra thick, or stopping it at the receiver by isolating the floor from the existing floor, if you put a floating floor up, or by putting pads or isolators like this under the feet of your bed if it's vibrating your bed. Now, that source, path, receiver. Now, another way, let's start with source again. Putting springs underneath a, or on top of a ceiling fan or a air conditioner or some device, the motor that's maybe hanging from the ceiling, is only partially effective because, again, it's not air. Ceilings have a limited amount of vibration reducing ability. This is why you need a consultant, something I'll probably say 10 times in the next few minutes. Because with the wrong springs, it amplifies the vibration. You remember pogo sticks?
Yes.
Okay. They would amplify your vibration. They would amplify. So it's got to be done right. Now, another way of making something that isolates better than the spring is to use air by supporting the fan from the floor of the restaurant rather than from the ceiling of the restaurant. That way there's no direct connection. Doing something to the construction of the giant concrete slab or the thin wood floor, whatever you've got, is generally not an option unless you're building the building from scratch. Right. Putting in a floating floor, again, has limitations because normally you use something like, very often people put in these sheets of rubber, and they usually use recycled rubber, and there's a number of products that do that. Some of them look like a Brillo pad, you know, expanded polystyrene with lots of fibers, but it shapes sort of like a sponge, and you put your floor on top of that. They don't work 100% either, but they certainly don't work as well as springs that are well designed. So that's the other option. Now, let me backtrack and say we already talked about stopping the vibration at the source, through the path, or at the receiver, okay? When you are trying to reduce vibration, one of the things that first has to be determined is whether or not you're talking about structural vibration. There's two types of noise that people complain about or that affect most people. One is called airborne and one's called structure-borne. Now, if in the example below, we're talking about not just vibration from a fan, or an air conditioner that's attached to the ceiling below, but music, which has loud bass, boom, 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 coming from the restaurant below, or the resident below, or the boiler room below, or the elevator room above. These noises, which you may feel, because you may feel your floor shaking, may feel your ceiling shaking, you may feel your body shaking, but you may also hear. And usually when people call me up and say, I have a vibration problem, it's not because things are shaking physically, like their floor or their ceiling, at least not that in any detectable way to a person. Instead, they're referring to low frequency bass sound in the air. Now let's get back to the terms airborne and structure borne. Airborne sound is generally meant to be sound that goes through the air or that is originally produced in the air. Structure-borne sound is generally referred to when they talk about the sound of footsteps from the neighbor walking upstairs, okay, because it's structure-borne. But if a person is talking loudly upstairs, or if a person is screaming happy birthday in the restaurant downstairs, or if they're playing loud music in the restaurant downstairs or next door, for that sound to get to you, it has to go into the air. It shakes the ceiling or the wall or the floor that separates you from them. And in so doing, in that shaking, that airborne sound, which is produced in the air, becomes structure-borne. Gets to your house, your home, wherever you are, and is radiated into the air from that vibrating surface. So once again, it becomes airborne. So the fact is most airborne sound complaints have a structure-borne component to them also. I mean, obviously, if you and I were in the same room, there's no structure-borne sound. What people generally will hear on the other side of a wall or a floor or a ceiling is just the muffled woo, 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 woo. They won't understand the crisp intelligibility of the vowels and the consonants and the syllables. They can't necessarily understand the words, but they hear the bass part of it. And then if they try to measure it with a phone app on their iPhone or something, they will generally not pick up the bass parts very well. And they call me up and they say, I don't have a sound problem. I have a vibration problem. And I say, no, wait a second. If you put a bowl of water on your desk table and you see it shaking like the T-Rex in Jurassic Park, then you got a structural vibration problem. That if that's bothering you, the shaking, if that's what's bothering you, no. What's bothering me is the booming sound. Oh, well, okay. In that case, what you're calling vibration is really low frequency sound. Now, I should also back up and say that all sound is vibration and all vibration is sound. But if the sound is going through the air, or at least the important part, and maybe the fact that you're hearing it, is obviously hitting your eardrums because of the air, then it's low frequency sound. Let's not call it vibration. Vibration is when things are shaking. Vibration affects MRI machines. You don't get clear images. But the vibration can also be uncomfortable because you're feeling some shaking occurring. And you may not hear anything. But when the vibration is in the air and the air molecules are vibrating, they vibrate your eardrums, it becomes what we would call sound. So, as I said before, if you put in springs, you have to do it right, because if you don't do it right, you could either not get as benefit as you expect or hope. It may actually amplify the vibration as well. It can also have other effects like the device breaking or falling down or hurting somebody. You got to do it the right way. And even the right products have to be installed the right way. Products like these pads that people put underneath their floating floors because they figure, well, I really can't get the neighbor downstairs to do what I want them to do. They might be a residential neighbor, a commercial neighbor. It might be the building's boiler room. So I'm just going to put in my own floating floor. Most of the products that are being sold by the acoustical companies are so hyped up that they hype them up, not necessarily by saying something that won't work will work, but by something saying something that won't work for that purpose will work. Products like pads underneath floors are good at reducing noises of a certain type from going downstairs when you walk or drop things on the floor from going downstairs. They don't generally work in the opposite direction. Also, when you were saying before that when you're talking in a room, it turns into bass when it goes into the wall, what actually happens, and the reason why you hear bass coming through the wall, is because bass is usually the most pervasive sound that is able to penetrate through the wall. In the case of loud music, bass is usually the loudest sound to begin with, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
If you buy like a little white noise machine because you're being bothered by bass, the white noise machine doesn't put out bass. And because it doesn't put out bass, it's not able to mask bass. It's not able to cover up the offending bass. So you have bass that starts out louder than anything else, is able to transmit through walls, ceilings, floors, and windows more than anything else, and is the hardest thing to mask with your masking machine.
So, in summary, in most situations, what you think is just a vibration problem is probably also a noise problem. The best way to stop noise or vibrations is at the source. One of the most effective ways to stop vibration from transferring from ceilings and floors is by attaching the noise-making machinery with springs. However, it needs to be done correctly or it can make the problem worse. There might be some anti-vibration pads that you can use at the source, but the pads you choose depend on the type and frequency of the noise. And on rare occasions, you might be able to reduce vibration at the receiving end if your problem is truly caused only by vibration, like water spilling out of a bowl. If noise is involved, like bass, it won't make any difference if you put your furniture on anti-vibration pads at the receiving end. I hope this helps. And I'd like to thank Al Fierstein for joining us. Please check out his website at acoustilog.com. I'll put a link in the description. He's got a lot of information on there about noise and sound. And of course, for more information about noise resources, visit soundproofist.com.